Hi, Alex here from Rebeloper.com, and welcome back to this video and welcome back to the series about rejects. And in this episode, we are going to talk about how to validate passwords. So without further ado, let's get started. Okay. If you already haven't done so, go ahead and take a look at the previous videos in this episode series, because we have already built up our example project and we already have validated age and email. And today we are going to validate password. But because this project is set up and I don't want to go through it again, go ahead and take a look at those videos so you may better understand the logic and the structure of this project. Now, let's dive into checking or validating passwords. Now, why do we need to validate passwords? Well, we want to validate them because we want our users to have strong passwords. Now, strong passwords have letters, capitals and small letters, numbers, special characters, and they must be at least 6 characters long. So this is what we are going to implement and check for validity with rejects in this episode of Rejects Mania. So that is the name of our project. So let's jump right into it and take a look at our extensions. Validity type, we have 2 types of validity, age and email. So let's add another one here, case password. And let's just wait for it. As usual, as you could see in the previous video, we have started adding the next switch case here, and I am just going to copy and paste that in there. I'm going to change the case to password, and of course the reject shouldn't be email, but it should be case password. And I'm just going to leave it as an empty string for now. So let's add that in here. Okay, one last thing that we need to change, and I'm going to come back to the rejects in just a moment before we dive into it deeper, is to change the validity type inside our root view controller to password. Now let's get back to the good stuff. So here we have our rejects. In the age, we have numbers, minimum number 2, maximum count of the string 2. Email, a lot of stuff, but here we have at and the dot and the minimum number of the characters 2 and maximum 64. Now, as you might have guessed, the password is much more complicated. So again, I just copy and paste it from our test example here, and let me just copy again, no peeking for the website, but if you did, go ahead and do. But we have some awesome explanation in the next video. So what do we have here? Well, it's kind of a crazy gibberish talk here, but let me just try to comprehend it for you and make a gist of it. So this symbol says that, okay, we are starting. Now, with the question mark, as you might have guessed, if it has okay, if it doesn't have an okay. So we have all of these, and this is a wildcard parameter. What this basically does is it validates a password that has small letters, capital letters, and special characters. I don't really recall what this does. Maybe a space. It doesn't have a space or something like that. I don't really know, but it does the job. And it has to be at least 6 characters and at most 25 characters. Now again, if you want to dive even deeper into rejects, go ahead and take a look at this link. And let me just jump right into it. This cheat sheet explains it all. Here we have our special characters here, pattern modifiers and so on, if you wanted to. But this is a great way to set up our password validation. Go ahead and simply just copy and paste it out just like I did. No, I believe we are ready to test it out. Let's just double check. Yep, we did set this to password, and let's build and run and see our password being validated instantly. Okay, let's type in our password. Of course, if we wanted to, we could set this to be a password text field. And as a bonus, I will just show you that in just a sec. But for now, let us just see the password, what we are typing in. So let's say we want to have password, not a valid password. Let's see. 123123, not a valid password. So let's add in here a valid password already. So what I like to do is add all of the characters, and this really helps me out. A, S, an exclamation mark, 2, 3, and a 4. So it has it all. It has numbers, capital letters, small letters, special character, and it's really easy to remember. And I usually use this in test mode when I want to, let's say, log into Firebase. Okay, and that is a valid password. Really nice. If I just type a backspace there, it's still not a valid password. And why? Because it needs to have at least 6 characters. So let's jump back to with a 4. And that is it for this tutorial. How awesome was it? Now, again, if you don't know what I'm talking about here with this project, go ahead and click the link in the description so you may get the starter project. And of course, take a look at the previous videos, how we have built all of this out, because it's, of course, it's not all about the rejects here, but just simply copy and paste it. It's all about understanding the project that we are building. Now, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, go ahead and give it a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel, and hit that notification bell to get notified of new videos. And the next newest video in this tutorial series, and of course the last, will be about validating websites, and that will be a whole lot of fun. So, as usual, I will see you in the next one.